Okay, so that left hand's going to start on the C and the E. Okay, most of this is just going to be thirds. So we're just playing C and E. Okay, then A and C. F and A. G and B. And then back to the A and C. Okay, so that's the left hand. The right hand's going to start on an E. Okay, that little run in those little notes, okay? D, E, F, E, D, C, D, C. Okay? Then you move up to the A and just walk down the scale. Okay? Then you're going to play through that twice. Second time, at the end, after you come down that little scale, you're going to do a little third walk up here. Okay? So you're going to start on the D, D and F, and then you're just going to walk up to the C. The left hand's going to be playing that A and C the whole time, and then when you get to the C, it's going to go back to that first C and E. Okay, so all together, coming from the top, that sounds like this. Okay? So when you're playing this part now with the thirds, all you're doing is playing the same thing with the right hand, but with just an added third lower to it. Okay? All right, and then we jump up to the A, and we're playing an F there with it, and then we just walk down. Now, when you get to the B and the D, we're just going to go from B and D to B and C to A and C, okay? So, all right. Now, what you can do with the left hand, just to make it sound a little more full, is add octaves in. Can't do that, that's fine. It sounds fine the other way, but if you're able to, it adds a little more fullness to it. So after you play that through twice, you're gonna be doing the little down part right there. And that's just an A and an E on the left hand. And then A, B, C, and E on the right hand. Okay? So that sounds like this. And then you do that rest on the last part, and then that'll go into that really full part. And that part is, on the left hand, is going to start on an A, and then go B, C. Okay, and that's pretty fast, so it goes. And then we go to an F, and then an E. Okay? If you can't do that quick walk up, just play A and C. Now the right hand is just going to be playing the same chords. So it's A down here, A minor. When you walk up to the C, you're going to do a G, C, and E. So basically this C and E are just staying the same. And you're just switching between the A and the G. So it sounds like this. Okay? Then when you go down to the F, you're just playing an F chord and then an E chord. So together that sounds like this. Okay? Then you go into that verse. The verse is going to be an A, C, D, and E. So you're just doing that. With the right hand, you're going to be doing E, A, and C for that A minor. So when you first go into it, you're going to go back to that F and E. Okay? Okay? Then you go into the verse chords, which is that A to the C. And you're going to play E, G, and C. It's just a little inverted C chord. That's that D is going to be a D minor with F, A, and D. And then the E, it's just an E chord. Now, when you walk down the second time, you're going to do the little octave run down. And that just walks down from the E to the A, okay? So we're starting at, we have that E, and then you're going to play octaves, D, C, B, and A to walk back down. And then you're just playing octaves after that. So. Now, when you get to the end of that, it's going to be A, C, F, and then E. Okay, and that leads into the bridge. So it's going to be A. That bridge part, which starts on a C, G, C, and E with the right hand. And then we're going to go to an F and a C with the left hand, and an F7 with the right hand. So F, A, C, and E. So it starts on C. Then you're going to play C, D, E. And when you play that E, you're going to play an A minor chord with it. So it's going to be C, F7, okay? And then when you go to the next, you're going to go to a G, G and D with the left hand. And with the right hand, you're going to play G, B, and an E, and then you're going to resolve it to the D. So that's going to sound like this. Okay, then you're just going to repeat that. Okay, then it's going to be the C to the F7, and then you're going to do an F minor, which is F, G sharp, or A flat, C, and E again. Okay, so F minor. And then you're going to go back into that full part on the A minor. Okay. So that's going to have a stop on that second time, right? So it's the A minor. Same idea, though. Same chords. And then you're going to go into the verse again. Sorry. There we go. F and C. Or, sorry, F and E. And then you're going to play through the verse again. Out of the verse, you're going to go back into that bridge with the C and the F. And then you're just going to build that bridge. I like to play octaves on that part. Just hit it hard like Tyler likes to do. Build that big. Back into those intro chords, which is that C and the E. that's how you play implicit demand for proof.